to build a strong presence of God. Now you face each other two by two. You pray for the other person, see if the person feels the presence of the Holy Spirit. One person lay hand, face each other. Now, everyone now, try to find someone, lay hand on their person. Now, in a church generally, it's better that the man pray for the man and the woman pray for the woman.
As
pastors, we cannot avoid praying for people of the opposite sex. It's very important that we keep a pure heart. Okay, now try to find the same sex. If not, pray for someone that's okay.
Open your heart to God. Open your heart to God.
Oh.
Not to put the hand on top. Just lightly touch him on the side. Don't put weight. Like this.
Oh.
Love God while praying. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Two hands.
With two hands.
Oh, one person pray for the other one. The other person put down the hands. One person pray for the other one. The other one put down the hands. One person put down the hands. The person who received put down the hands.
We mushira amaboko hejuru ku bitugu.
One person pray for the other one, and the other one. The one who received prayer put down the hands.
Umwe niwanza gusengera undi. Gahoro woroheje, gahoro.
Hallelujah. Oh, Yesu.
We love you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now say this. Please keep your eyes closed. Have you experienced anything in the during the prayer? Okay, so the person who received prayer will answer. Okay, now. So the person who received prayer will answer. Now, so ask the person. Have you experienced anything during the prayer? Okay, those who experience something, the power of Holy Spirit, please raise your hand. Those who experience the power of Holy Spirit, please raise your hand. Okay, those who experience the Holy Spirit, please raise your hand. Raise your hand high up. Those who experience the Holy Spirit, raise your hand high up. Okay. Now reverse. The one who received prayer will pray for the other person. And then we cry to Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now say again. Please keep your eyes closed. Have you experienced anything during the prayer? Ask the person. So ask the person, has he experienced anything? Okay. Now, those who experience the Holy Spirit in the two times, anyone who experienced Holy Spirit, please raise your hand. Anyone? For the two times, raise your hand higher. Yes, anyone who have experienced the Holy Spirit, raise your hand higher. So you thank God. You thank God that you can carry the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You can carry the power of the Holy Spirit when you pray more. Okay, now do you have any questions just now? So the more we pray with the heart reaching out to God, then the more you experience God.
Okay,
do you have any questions, brother?
Yes.
Just
Number 1,
I want to appreciate you, so thank you first.
Thank you. Thank God.
You know, we are pastors, what you are teaching us, the word, it is within us, but it is good because you are building us again. And every person gives out what God has given him. You give out what you have. When you reached here, you taught us about God's love. For sure, we are getting that. We understand. And now we are catching up with that love. We are loving more God.
Thank you.
So God of Chinese, God of whites, God of Westerners, is God, is God of Rwandans. So God doesn't show partiality. So the peace world needs, it is with the God. God has given that peace to Chinese, has given it to Japanese, has given it to Rwandans, has given it to Westerners, has given it to Kenyans, has given it to everyone. That is the same peace we need because Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Now I have a question.
Now
I have a question.
turiko ubuziranenge kibabyemera none abantu bigisha iby'Imana kugira ngo tumenye ibyo ubuziranenge kuko byose bisa naho usanga bisa twabipimira koki icyo cyo kibazo.
The question is this. You know, I know God has filled everyone the power of the Holy Spirit. I mean those who know Jesus. And people come to teach us from different areas of the world. They come teaching the power of the Holy Spirit, but they teach in different ways. But what shows that someone is filled with the Holy Spirit? In Rwanda, we have a Bureau of Standards. That Bureau of Standards, when goods come from outside, there is a mark that to prove that this thing is right, this thing is good, because of the mark of Bureau of Standards. Then, how can we know that? How can we understand that this is real, the power of the Holy Spirit? This person is carrying the real Holy power of the Holy Spirit, the anointing of God, because there's some of the things that are counterfeit.
Okay. Well, first is the teaching. Use the teaching and the life of the person. From the teaching, you can see his relationship with God. And from his life, we can see his relationship with God.
And
then when they pray for you, what you experience? Does it strengthen your Christian faith? Does it give you joy and love and peace? So mainly from the teaching and the life and also how when he prayed for people. Now I've heard people that they are evangelists or they are churches that emphasize on money. And they say, if you want more money, give more money. Now it's right for us to give. And God does reward us too. But when we give, we don't think, God, when will you give it back to me? Some people say, if you need a lot of money, then you give a lot, and then God will give you back more. We don't give and think of, oh, next week, next month, God will give the money back to me. So to me, this is a prosperity theology. We give, we love God because God is love. Not to get something back. But God does reward us. But we don't do it
in order to get money back.
Ariko ntabwo tujya tubikorera yo gukora umurimo w'Imana, twubaka umurimo w'Imana, ntabwo tubikora kugira ngo Imana yongere dusubize ejo bundi ejo bundi.
I also heard their teachings very strange, that's not found in the Bible.
Rero hari abandi bigisha n'inyigisho zitaboneka muri Bibiliya.
I heard a teaching that, you know, many different things are evil spirit.
Hari abantu benshi rero bigisha bavuga ngo ibintu byose, ikintu cyose babonye bakacyita umwuka mubi.
Now, is that true or not? The Bible doesn't say it.
Ese byo ni ukuri ko Bibiliya itanabivuga, umuntu watangwaga ahura n'isazi ngo ni umwuka mubi, wahura n'ikintu cyose kandi ari icyaremwe Imana yaremye kiraho.
So if someone says something that is not in the Bible, then you ask him, where is it in the Bible?
Umuntu rero nakubwira ikintu kitari muri Bibiliya, uzamubaze ngo byanditse he muri Bibiliya.
And if he cannot show that it's from the Bible,
ni umuntu atashobora kukwereka umurongo muri Bibiliya,
or he twists the Bible,
cyangwa se hari n'abandi baturika Bibiliya.
What do you mean twist the Bible?
Ni mvuka rero guturika Bibiliya ndavuga iki?
You know, the Bible is written for people to understand.
Urabona Bibiliya yandikiwe kugira ngo abantu basobanukirwe.
When you read the whole passage, you can find out what it means.
Iyo usomye rero Bibiliya uhereye ku murongo wa mbere ukarangiza igice cyose, wumva ubusobanuro.
That from the wording in the Bible, you can understand what it means.
Rero uhereye umurongo wa mbere w'igice runaka ukarangiza icyo gice, wumva ubusobanuro bw'icyo icyo Bibiliya ivuga.
Some people always look for special meaning that is not in the Bible.
Ariko umuntu umwe ashobora gufata amakantu akagasobanura bisobanuro bijyanye n'inyungu yishakira.
When something is not clearly explained in the Bible, we don't accept that as a doctrine.
Rero akantu katasobanutse neza, iyo ntabwo tubyemera rwose nk'inyigisho ikwiye kwigishwa mu itorero.
So we ask them, where you get this teaching from?
Ahubwo tushobora kubona umuntu arimo gucurika inyigisho twapfa kubaza ngo ariko wowe izi nyigisho zikura he?
And if you find that he's not teaching from the Bible,
hanyuma nusanga yigisha ibitava muri Bibiliya,
then don't follow or listen.
Ariko ushatse rwose wamwima amatwi, amatwi umwavunira mu biti.
Or if you see his behavior, there's something strange.
Rero ubonye n'umuntu afite imyifatire nanone mibi.
He lift up himself.
Yi afite ubwibone.
More powerful than other people.
Yigize igihangange kuruta abandi bantu bose.
You have to come to, if they say, you have to come to me to get the blessings.
Uwo muntu akubwiye ngo muze ngo muze munsange kugira ngo mubone imigisha, ariko yuzuye ubwibone.
If he's proud, then I was, you know, if you know for sure he's proud, then don't accept his prayer. Now, I have said many ways that God has blessed me, but I always say, I'm not worthy of it.
Ariko buri gihe cyose mpora nshira Imana bugufi bwa ngo, Mana, nubwo umpaye umugisha sinari mbikwiriye.
God chose me when I was weak.
Imana yanturanije kuko nari umunyantege nkeya cyane.
And what God wants to give this message to all people, not just to the pastors.
Imana inturanije nari n'umunyabyaha mubi cyane, ariko Imana irantoranya kandi imigisha Imana idufitiye irashaka kuyiha buri muntu wese, buri mushumba.
So it's not lifting up one person above the other ones.
Rero ntabwo bisobanura ko Imana izamura umuntu umwe gusa kurusumbisha abandi.
And also, I sincerely give thanks to God and glory to God.
Rero buri gihe mpora nca ubugufi nshimira bivuye ku mutima wanjye, nyiha icyubahiro kuko gikwiriye.
From my teaching and from my words, you can always see that I really like God.
Kandi mu by'ukuri namwe niba mubibona uko nseka ntibibereka ko nkunda Imana, iyo nigisha mubona ntakunda Imana, ese ukuntu ntambuka mubona ntakunda Imana koko?
Okay, so discern the teaching and the life.
Rero iyo tuvuga kwigisha ubuzima, kumenya imyigishirize ukamenya n'ubuzima bw'uwo muntu.
I've heard that there are many evangelists, they just want money, or they want, you know, they have things that is not in the Bible, we don't want to follow them.
Rero twamaze kubona ko hari n'abandi bigisha baza mu rusengero aje kwigisha, ntugira ngo ni urukundo bazaniye, akaza bashaka kubakuramo amafaranga, barahari baza, bateye batyo.
One question, I'd yes. like to know, to understand, you know, what the difference for the Holy Spirit, how can I understand the Holy Spirit and the Body Spirit?
Okay. And what spirit? Holy Spirit and a bad spirit.
Yeah. Or evil spirit.
How can you differentiate?
The difference between.
Now I want to say one more thing to answer the first question before that. Another thing is some preachers, they don't use the Bible. They just talk about many, many things, but not talking about the Bible. So watch out for that too.
Okay.
Now, Holy Spirit, evil spirit, the Bible tells very clearly from the fruit you can see. The Holy Spirit will give us peace, love, and joy, and help us to have a closer relationship with God. Not just during the time of the meeting, but afterwards you notice the difference.
Umwuka wera ntabazabana natwe igihe cy'amateraniro gusa, ahubwo azabana natwe turasohotse no mu rusengero, azatuyobora agenda twigisha.
When you go home, you find a continual motivation to pray to God, and you find it easier to pray to God and experience His love and joy.
Nunataha uko wavuye mu rusengero ubere iyo ngiyo, umwuka wera azajya kuyobora gusenga. Nusenga wumva ibyishimo, wumva uranezere, wumve wifitiye amahoro.
And the evil spirit will bring, you know, negative feelings, sadness, anger, or desire to suicide, wanted suicide. And I want to say something too. There are, you know, I have built one pastor who said he was a pastor, but he has, you know, he, when he prayed for the women or the girls, he will hug them. And also he talks about women, that he likes the woman. That one so-called pastor.
I don't know. We see it in Rokarumushumba. I call now to come to Mushumba. Since you are when you are a good way, I call Womushumba, never get more over. Womushumba, go to choose your Yigisha, go on a Yigisha, go over a Vadamo, our zero and distance.
And then, when he prayed for people, I saw that these people have, the reaction is out of control. Now yesterday, the people experienced joy. At first, they were really jumping for a short time. But that's only in the beginning. They don't continue to jump and out of control, get out of control in the body.
Continually.
But I saw this so-called pastor when he prayed for people. These people kick and out of control. You have to have four people hold them and take off the shoes. It's very out of control. Now, sometimes when people drive out demons, will be like that. But when it's not driving out demons, when you pray for people, people just get crazy out of control like that. Then it could be evil spirit.
Rero ikindi n'umubona umuntu asengera abantu ukabona birabarenze cyane hari igihe nanone bishobora iyo byabaye ibintu by'indengakamera igihe ishobora kuba ari imyuka mibi yuzuye mu bantu.
And also you can tell that from the teaching of the person too.
Ibyo nabyo bishobora kukwereka kumenya imyigishirize y'umuntu ukamenya uwo ari we.
If you can sense selfishness or wickedness or bad intention in the person's preaching, there could be something wrong.
Buriya ushobora kubona umuntu ufite imigambi mibi, umuntu ufite imitekerezo mibi, umuntu ufite mbese mu ntego ze zose ukabona ni bibi gusa, mbese muri we n'imyigishirize ye ukabona ariko afite ukuntu akoreka nabwo ukamenya ko uwo muntu afite umwuka mubi.
Let me ask one question. After I pray for you, when you go home and pray, and then, you know, this is the third day already. When you pray, have you noticed help? Have you noticed help? If you notice help now, can you raise your hand? After I pray for you, that you find that it's easier to pray or experience the Holy Spirit easier and it helps you spiritually, could you raise your hand?
Yo ubuye uno munsi wa gatatu ese iyo ugeze mu rugo ujye ukomeza ugasenga ese iyo usenze wabonye ukuntu ari byiza byaba cyarakuryoheye niba waravuye ahangaha wagera mu rugo ugasenga ukamara umwanya munini usenga ukagira uburyohe bwo gusenga
bikakuryohera ukabikunda manika ukuboko.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So you can tell from the people whether it helps them spiritually.
Rero ibyo wabibwira abantu ko ari ubuzima buzira umuze, ubuzima bufite intungamubiri mu isi y'umwuka. Ibyo mwabishimira Imana mwabibwira n'abandi. Haleluya.
Ikibazo mbaza ni ikibazo cyerekeye umwuka wera. Hari aho twize ko umwuka wera uri ubwoko bubiri. Umwuka wera uri mu bihe bibiri. Hari umwuka wera ufite urwego rwo hejuru, uza uri mu rwego rwo hejuru. Hakaba hari n'umwuka wera uza mu rwego ruciriritse, woroheje. Urakoze. Noneho uwo mwuka wera uri mu rwego rworoheje igihe uwufite ukawubona uwufite uri mu rwego rworoheje, icyo gihe ntabwo ushobora kwigisha abakristu bagahinduka. Iyo ni icyo kibazo mbajije.
Okay, I can use the mic. The simple question, even this man said, he can answer.
Okay.
He said that he learned something, that the Holy Spirit is in two phases. Two phases. There is the powerful Holy Spirit and the simple Holy Spirit. That is in two ways.
He operates in two ways.
Gentle.
Okay.
So very powerful one and very gentle. Then this guy said he can answer.
What did he say?
When he had that question.
Oh, I'll answer. But did he answer him already?
No, hasn't answered.
Okay, I'll answer that. Now the Bible does talk about the Holy Spirit who moves in the heart to bring us to repentance and faith in God and the fruit of the Holy Spirit. All these are the work of the Holy Spirit that's more gentle.
Reka ariko reka mbabwire umwuka wera aha akagera akora umurimo woroheje akora n'umutima w'ubugwaneza.
But the Bible also talks about strong anointing and strong power of the Holy Spirit.
Ariko nanone Bibiliya ikavuga ku mbaraga z'umwuka wera zo mu rwego rwo hejuru. Okay, umwuka wera ariko akorera mu mavuta aremereye.
Now actually someone said earlier, the person said every Christian is filled with the Holy Spirit. I disagree with that. Every Christian has the Holy Spirit, but not every Christian is filled with the Holy Spirit.
Ariko reka mbabwire, ntabwo jye nemera umuntu uvuga ngo buri muntu wakijijwe wese yuzuye imbaraga z'umwuka wera. Oya, ntabwo bose buzuye izo mbaraga. Ariko icyo nemera nuko hari abuzura izo mbaraga kandi iyo wuzuye izo mbaraga ushobora gukora imirimo ikomeye.
It's like a bottle of water.
Ngo nabigereranya n'icupa ry'amazi.
Every Christian has the Holy Spirit.
Reka mvuga ngo buri mukristo afite umwuka wera.
But when people have very close relationship with God, then the Holy Spirit will fill him more.
Ariko iyo umuntu reka mvuga ngo umuntu wese afite umutima wo gukunda Imana, afite umwuka w'Imana, ariko iyo ugiranye ubusabane n'Imana, umwuka w'Imana arakuzura.
Now in the book of Acts we see that they were filled with the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost and they all speak in
tongues. And there
was much healing.
And then
also in the Old Testament in 1 Samuel chapter 10 and chapter 19, you can write this down. 1 Samuel chapter 10 and chapter 19. There it talks about a group of prophets being trained by Samuel. And then when Saul went to them, immediately he started to prophesy.
So
there was a strong presence of God. And also Elijah and Elisha, there are a lot of miracles, a lot of
strong power.
So when we pray
more,
there'll be more miracles,
and people
will experience the Holy Spirit much stronger when
they are open.
Like yesterday, you saw the three persons filled with joy
because
they were very open,
and then the
Holy Spirit filled them filled up to a certain extent, a high degree, and then they were filled with the joy. That's a stronger presence of God. And a stronger presence of God can bring a greater change if the person responds to God.
So that's
a strong anointing of the Holy Spirit, a strong presence of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.